Yeah, which is ENT 121, and the course code is general management. This course is mainly for graduate level second semester. Today in this episode we are going to cover only one chapter, which is chapter one. And the course the topic for chapter one is concept of management. When we are talking about management, there are so many experts who define the word management. But the most popular definition is divided by Mary Packlett Follett. She defined management as getting things done through other people's effort. That is the definition of Mary Packlett Follett. It means she divided management as handing your responsibility to other people, to let other people take up your responsibility in order to achieve a common goal. And there's another definition of management. Management is just a systematic way of doing things, and the step at which you take in achieving an objective is also the definition of management. So when I'm talking about management, a person who is involved in this art is called a manager. So the manager is the one that supervises the body of an organization. It's not also the body of the organization, but some external body outside the organization. So we are going to look at the management function that we have. Under this management, we are going to look at 8 management functions that we have. The first one is planning. Second one is organizing. Third one is leading. Fourth one is staffing. The fifth one is coordinating. The sixth one is delegating. The seventh one is controlling, and the last one is decision making. So let's start from planning. Planning, what is planning? Planning is a way a program is being projected on how a program is being projected on how the available resources will be utilized. And in order to achieve a stated objective, we are talking about planning. You know, when you want to start a business, you know, there are some ways, there are some steps you have to follow. For example, a person who wants to start a poultry farm, you know, there are some things you have to get. There are some resources you have to get. The resources must be on ground. The first thing is a land. The second thing is a land where water is close by. That is the second thing, and the next one is capital. So the process of doing all these things is planning. That means the person is making a plan on the business he wants to establish. So that is the first management. That is the first management function. The second one is organizing. When we are talking about organizing is just a process of identifying and guiding of responsibility. You know, when you're talking about organizing is just about in a company, there are so many departments in an organization. We have sales departments, we have marketing departments. And this department, the tasks they perform are very different from each other. The tasks sales department perform is different from marketing department. So the process of identifying their tasks to be performed is organizing. The process of telling the sales department, this is what you are going to do, this is your duty. The process of telling the marketing department, this is what you are going to do, this is your duty, is organizing. You are putting things together. You are putting their responsibility, you are putting their duty, you are putting it together. So that is organizing. So we are talking about, the next one is leading. So when you are talking about leading, leading simply means getting the employee towards the leader assigned for them to do. It's just a way in which a manager make sure he guides, he supervise and the subordinates, telling them what they are going to do. If any the process of assign a task for them, telling them this is what you are going to do, and you also supervise them, you also guide them, and you also command them to do certain objectives. That is leading. So the next one is staffing. When you are talking about staffing, staffing is an important role in an organization, and it's an important role in management too. It's just the process of recruiting, training, employing, and promotion of employees. In an organization where there are not enough employees, the organization cannot go very well. So the process of employing another people into the organization, and before you employ another people into the organization, there must be promotion that must have been occur in the organization. If promotion did not occur, then some people might have retired in the organization in order to employ another set of people to the organization. So that is staffing. The process of employing them, you train them on that duty, you train them, you select the capable one among them, is staffing. So the next one is coordinating. When you are talking about coordinating involves supervising all the departments in an organization. You know, I talk about leading. Leading is just about supervising only one department. But when I'm talking about coordinating involves supervising all the departments to make sure they work toward the stated objective. You know, in an organization, there is only one objective that is being stated down, in which all departments work toward. So the process of supervising all departments in that organization is coordinating. So you are coordinating all the departments in the organization. So that is coordinating. So the next one is delegation. When you're talking about delegation is the process. It's when a leader assigns a responsibility to a subordinate. This is when a leader assigns a responsibility to a subordinate. What we are trying to say in this delegation, you know, for example, in a tailoring company, there are so many works to be done. There are so many works to be done in a tailoring company. Some people are to cut clothes. Some people are to iron clothes. Some people are to sew the clothes. So for a leader to assign, this is what you are going to do, this is what you are going to do, this, you are going to be in ironing department. You are going to be in cutting department. You are going to be in the cutting process of the clothes. So that is delegation. So it also makes work easier. So it can also be called division of labor. This delegation. So the next one is controlling. When you are talking about controlling is the process by which a manager ensures that the stated objective of an organization is being achieved. No matter what is stake, no matter how they are going to do it, the manager ensures that the stated objective of the organization must be achieved. So that is controlling. So the last one is decision making. When you are talking about decision making is the process of finding solution to problems, of choosing between alternatives. As a manager, you must be able to find solution to arising problem in the organization. There are so many problems that an organization face. They face some internal problems, they face some external problems. So the process of you finding solution to that problem, you must be able to think and find solution to a problem arising in the organization. This is the process by which you find solution to a problems. So we have come to the end of today's episode. Please kindly drop your comments or question and the comment in the comment box on how we can improve, all your suggestion on how we can improve. Please kindly like and subscribe to our channel. Thank you.